city of Hartford as an entirety, parents, students, community groups, myself, the Board of Ed, anything and anyone who's in the community should be held accountable, from business owners to nonprofits, to churches. There is not one single person who should not be held accountable for the state of our education. We all have a role on making sure that our children are educated and have the best education system put in place for them to go on to higher education. And I think that we have all failed our children in that area. So I don't think that it's an Adamowski problem. I don't think that it's a Mayor Perez problem. I think that it is a community problem and that we all must address it.
The key to the whole thing is to start early enough to teach our kids and give them such a strong background in the basic things. Then they'll be willing to go. Whether it's the classroom or the athletic field or the field house, I feel like I'm in a position to do any of these things, so therefore, let's get it on. Come on, baby, let's go. You don't frighten me. I feel good about being in any situation where, just give me a chance, all right, after everybody is finished, then I want you to hear my point of view.
The youth today don't have that much confidence in adults, do they?
No.
You gotta learn to have the confidence. You gotta go back and you gotta find the people who are gonna give you the right answers. It may take you four or five people. People may not take you serious. But you're gonna find that one person that's gonna be willing to sit down with you and help you structure out where you wanna go.
My parents always showed by their example. They always told us what we could accomplish.
People think I was doing it for all the other children. I was simply doing it for my own children. That was what I was. I was really doing it for my children. So if they got better lunches and all the kids got better lunches, that's okay. I'm not frowning on that, but my kids got better lunches. If we got rid of a bad teacher, and every other kid got rid of that same bad teacher, that's already, long as my children didn't have to deal with it, or apology that didn't work against them, you know, long as my children, selfish motives, my children, ones that I had to put to bed, that I had to care for, that I brought into the world.
I invest a lot into their education. We spend a lot of time learning and just trying to do constructive things with the children, because I'm looking to them to aspire to become greater than whatever it is that I have accomplished in my life.
I would love for my children to have had the love and the care and the concern of concerned parents and teachers, concerned teachers in school like I did. I had teachers who not only were my teacher, they were kind of my surrogate mom and dad, you know, so if I was over in the schoolyard messing around, you know, I got in trouble for that, just like I would have got in trouble in the neighborhood.
Well, Mr. Morrison, there was not one parent he did not know. And I always found that impressive, that every child in the whole school, Mr. Morrison knew their parents. And I think that impacted my life as a young person, because I knew that there was this team effort going on between my parents and my school. Did I like it? No. I remember being young thinking that it was the worst thing, but it was the beginning years of me learning how to read, and I thought that was very critical, that partnership between the school, the principal, and my parents was formulated.
Quality of education, it takes the parent, the child, teachers, administration, all of us collaboratively work together and to ensure that child is getting the best education that he or she can get.
A parent should come into the school, take a day off from work, Take a day off from work. Go into the classroom. See what that teacher is doing. Assist that teacher. Sit over to the side. Help a student read. They should take an active part.
The most powerful way a parent can provide ongoing input is at the school level, in their child's school. First of all, make sure your child attends, you know, school every day. And then show up at PTO meetings. Show up or volunteer for a school governance council meeting. And I'll stop there for a second, because every school is going to have a school governance council where teachers, administrators, parents, reps and community reps will sit together to make major decisions for that school. And that's a great way for parents to be in a leadership role.